Kansas City Fringe Festival, and I'm here to welcome you to Teen Fringe. This is our first year doing it like this, doing this expanded programming, and we're really excited about it. The Fringe Festival, for anybody who doesn't know, it's an 11-day arts festival that happens around this time of year every year. This is our 13th year, and it's really an inexpensive way for artists to put on a show. So it's a great place for experimentation. We get artists, we get theater people from all over, playwrights from all over, creating new things. That's the main thing of Fringe, because there's no censorship. You can do whatever it is you want. And the artists get most of that money, and they get 60%, venue gets 30, Fringe gets 10%. So keep that in mind. Right now, they're in 16 different venues around the city. We're in almost every theater in the area. And Teen Fringe, what happened with that is Kara came to me and said that KC Young Audiences would like to be a venue for Teen Fringe. So that opened it up wide open. We'd been just doing open mic nights at the Plaza Library, but this gave us an opportunity to do expanded shows for teens. So keep an eye out for us next year, because we're really hoping to do this. It'll be sometime around this time. Teen tickets are $5 normally. I got a special deal on teen buttons for $1. For the regular Fringe, they're $5, but your $1 button works the same as a $5 button. So next year, keep that in mind too. And I think that's it. Thank you guys for coming. We appreciate you being here and hope to see you next year.
Jack's found a fortune now, my dear lady. Where should this music be? The air or the earth? I called it. Where it hath drawn me rather. But 'tis gone. No, it begins again. Ah, the ditty does remember my drowned father.
The fringed curtains of the eye advance, say what thou seest yonder.
What is? A spirit? Lord, thou looks so loud. Believe me, sir, care is a great warmth, which is a spirit.
No wench, it eats and sleeps, and hath such sense as sleep. This gallant which thou seest was in the wreck, yet lost his fellows and strays about to find them.
I might call him a thing divine, but nothing natural I ever saw so noble.
Most sure the goddess in whom these airs attend, vouchsafe my prayer may know if you remain upon this island, my primal crest which I do last pronounces. Oh, you wonder if you be maid or no.
No wonder, sir, but certainly a maid.
My language? Heavens! Myself of Naples, who with mine eye, never since I have beheld the king, my father wrecked.
Alack, for mercy!
Yes, faith in all his lords.
A word! You have done yourself some wrong, a word.
Why speaks my father so ungently? This is the third man that e'er I saw, the first that e'er I sighed for. Pity move my father to be inclined my way.
We'll make you the queen of Naples.
Soft, sir. But one word more. I charge thee that thou dost here usurp the name thou owest not, and put thyself upon this island as a spy, to wean it from me, the lord of.
No, as I am a man.
Silence, speak not you for him, he's a traitor. Come, follow, I'll manacle thy neck and feet together. Sea water shalt thou drink, thy food shall be withered roots, fresh brook mussels and husks were in the acorn cradle. Follow!
No, ours is just entertainment, so my enemy has more power.
Oh, dear father, make not too rash a trial of him, for he is gentle and not fearful.
Put up thy sword,
I beseech you, father!
Hence, hang not on my garment. There are no more such shapes as he.
My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man.
Come on. Thou hast done well.
Be of comfort. My father's of a better nature, sir, than he appears by speech.
Speak not for him. Come.
Your name?
Miranda.
Admired Miranda, indeed the top of admiration, what's dearest to the world? Oh, you, so perfect and so perilous, made of every creature's best.
I do not know one of my sex, nor woman's phrase remember, save for my glass my own. No have I seen more than I might call men than you, good friend, and my dear father. How features are abroad, I am skillless of but by my modesty, the jewel and my dower. I would not wish any companion in the world but you, nor can imagine any form or shape besides yourself to like of. But I prattle something too wildly, and my father's precepts I therein do forget.
I mean my condition, a prince, Miranda. I do think a king. I would not so, you know, I so speak. The very instant that I saw you did my heart fly to your service. For your sake am I this patient, long man.
Do you love me?
Oh, heaven! Oh, earth! Bear witness to the sound. I, beyond the limit of what else that the world you love, prize, honor you.
I am a fool to weep of what I am glad of.
Wherefore weep you?
At mine unworthiness, that dare not offer what I desire to give a much less take. I am your wife, if you will marry me. If not, I'll die your maid.
My mistress dearest and I thus humble ever.
My husband, then?
I, with a heart as willing as bondage ere freedom, here's my hand.
And mine. And now, farewell, till half an hour hence.
A thousand thousands.
So glad of this is they, I cannot
be. Miranda, your daughter is in love.
She is mine own, and so be raised.
My lord, she is a woman. Though she is thine, she is her own. Let her live in love. Here I will show thee the joy and shine that love brings to you.
Two households, both alike in dignity, in fair Verona where we lay our scene. From ancient grudge break to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventure and piteous overthrows do with their death bury their parent strife.
Soft. What light of yonder window breaks? It is the east. Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon. It's already pale, sick with grief, that thou, maid, art far more fair than she. See how she leans her cheek upon her hand. Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
I mean.
She speaks. Speak again, bright angel.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
Deny thy father and refuse thy name.
Or, if thou wilt not,
be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more, or shall I speak at this?
'Tis but thy name that is my enemy.
What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other word would smell as sweet.
Romeo,
doff thy name, and for thy name which is no part in thee, take all myself!
I take yet thy word. Call me but love, and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth I never will be Romeo.
What man art thou that thus bescreened knight so stumblest on my counsel?
By a name, I know not how to tell thee who I am. My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself, because it is an enemy to thee.
Art thou not Romeo? And Montague?
Neither, fair maid, if either be disliked.
How camest thou hither? Tell me, and wherefore? The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and this place death, considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find me here.
With love's light wings did I approach these walls.
Dost thou love me? I know thou wilt say aye.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon I swear.
Swear not by the moon! The inconstant moon, lest thy love prove likewise variable.
What shall I swear by?
Do not swear then. Or if thou wilt, swear by thy gracious self.
If my heart's dear love.
Do not swear at all. Although I joy in thee, I have no joy in this contract tonight. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden. Sweet, good night.
Juliet!
I hear some noise within. Dear love, to you.
Juliet!
I come anon, sweet Montague. True. Three words, dear Romeo, and good night indeed. If thy bent of love be honorable, thy purpose merry, send for me word tomorrow. By one I will procure to send it to thee. Where and what time thou wilt perform the rites. And
Tomorrow will I send.
So cried my soul.
Thousand times good night.
A thousand.
A thousand times the worst of what thy life.
Softing now, fair Ophelia. Nymph, in thy orisons be all my sins remembered.
Good, my lord, how does your honor for this many a day?
I humbly thank you well.
My lord, I have remembrances of yours that I have long and longed to re-deliver. I pray you now receive them.
Nope, not I. I never gave you aught.
My honored lord, you know right well you did, and with them words of love so sweet composed as it make the things more rich. Their perfume moss, take these again, there, my lord.
I did love you once.
Indeed, my lord, you made me believe so.
You should not have believed me. I loved you not.
I was the more deceived.
Get thee to a nunnery. Why wouldst thou be a breeder of sinners? Go thy ways to a nunnery.
Oh, help him, you sweet heavens.
Get thee to a nunnery. Farewell. Or if thou wilt needs marry, marry a fool, for wise men know well enough what monsters you make of them. To a nunnery, go, and quickly to farewell!
Heavenly powers restore him!
Go to. I'll have no more on it. It hath made me mad! I say, we will have no more marriage. Those that are married already, all but one shall live. The rest shall keep as they are. To a nunnery, go.
Oh, what a noble mind is here on throne. The courtiers, soldiers, scholars, eye, tongue, sword, the expectancy and rose of the fair state. The glass of fashion and the mold of form, the observed of all observers, quite.
Two men of grosser blood and teach them how to war! And you, yeoman whose limbs were made in England. Show us here the metal of your pasture! Let us swear that you're worth your breeding, which I doubt not, for there's none of you so mean and base that have that noble luster in your eyes. I see you stand like greyhounds in the slips, straining upon the start. The game's afoot. Fall your spirit in upon this charge. Strike God for Harry, England, and St. George!
Cheeks, God's mother deigned to appear to me, and in a vision full of majesty, she willed me to leave my base vocation and free my country of calamity. Her aid she promised and assured success. In complete glory she revealed herself. And whereas I was black and swart before with those clear rays which she did infuse on me, that beauty am I blessed with. Ask me again what question thou canst possible, and I will answer unpremeditated. My courage, try by combat, and thou shalt find that I exceed my sex! Enemies and rivals. Fate in hands, bashes
You do more cunning, more and more. When true of kill strength, though devilish holy fray, these vows are Hermia's, will you give her or?
I had no judgment when to her I swore.
Nor none in my mind, now you give her or.
Demetrius loves her and he loves not you.
Oh, Helen, goddess, nymph, perfect, divine, to what my love shall I compare thine eye? Oh, let me kiss this princess of bliss.
Spite! Oh, hell! I see you all are bent to set against me for your merriment. Can you not hate me? As I know you do, but you must join in souls to mock me, too. If you were men, as men you are, you should, you would not use a gentle lady so. You both are rivals and love Hermia.
Helena.
Hermia. And now both rivals to mock Helena.
Demetrius, you are unkind. Be not so, for you love Hermia. And this you know I know. And here, with all my goodwill, with all my heart, and Hermia's love, I yield you up my part. And yours and Helen to me, whom I do love and will do till my death.
Never did mockers waste more idle breath.
Say no keep thy Hermia, idle none. If e'er I love to old, that love is gone. My heart to her but as guestwise sojourned. And now to Helen, is it home returned? There to remain.
Helen, it is not, sir.
Now look where thy love comes. Yonder is thy dear. Oh.
Thou art not by mine eye, Lysander, found. Mine ear, I think it brought me to thy sound. But why unkindly didst thou leave me so?
Why should he stay whom love doth press to go?
What love could press Lysander from my side?
Lysander's love thou would never let abide. Why seekest thou me? Could not this show the hate I bear thee made me leave thee so?
You speak not as you think. It cannot be.
Lo, she is one of this confederacy. Now I perceive they have conjoined all three to fashion this false sport in spite of me. Injurious Hermia, most ungrateful maid, have you conspired, have you in me contrived to bait me with this foul derision?
Is all the counsel to be shared? The sister's vows, oh, is all forgotten. All the full childhood innocence.
And will you rent our ancient love's asunder to join with? Men? Demetrius, who even but now did spurn me with his foot to call me goddess, nymph, divine, rare. Wherefore speaks he this to her he hates? And wherefore doth Lysander deny her love? This sport, well carried, shall be chronicled. Fare you well.
Helen, stay! Dear, my excuse, my love, my life, my soul, gentle Helen.
Oh, excellent.
Helen, I love thee. By my life, I do. I swear by that which I will lose for thee to prove it false.
I say I love thee more than he can do.
Thou say so? Withdraw and prove it too.
Quick, come. Lysander!
Lift your dazzle! Hey, off thou cat, thou worm! I'll think that loose or will shake thee from me like a serpent.
Why have you grown so rude? What changes this sweet love?
Thy love? Out! Loathe of medicine, oh hated potion!
Hey!
Yes! Sooth, and so do you!
Demetrius, I will keep my word with thee.
I'll not trust.
What? Shall I hurt her? Strike her? Kill her dead? Although I hate her, I must harm her so.
What? Can you do me greater harm than hate? Hate me? Wherefore? Oh me, what news, my love? Am not I Hermia? Are not you Lysander? I am as fair now as I was erewhile, since now.
Your indulgence.